We welcome you to the Home Depot SEC from Jordan-Hare Stadium on the campus in Auburn, Alabama. The 114th meeting between these old SEC foes, the Bulldogs of Georgia and the Tigers of Auburn. This has been a tumultuous 10-day period for Cam Newton, for Auburn, for the SEC, and indeed for all of college football. Allegations have been made, investigations have been launched, reputations have been tarnished, insinuations have been leveled, and the truth seems enshrouded somehow in a thick gray fog. It's in there somewhere, isn't it? 2 hours ago, the man whose ability to play today has been in question, Cam Newton, made an enthusiastic jog through the Tiger fans as he made his way into Jordan-Hare Stadium, out through the tunnel, and on to Pat Dye Field. Students had been let in just prior to his arrival. He gathered his teammates at midfield, exhorted them one last trip to the student section, and then 30 minutes ago, the public address announcer announced the starting lineups.
And quarterback from College Park, Georgia, Glenn Junior College, number 2, Cam Newton.
Well, they seemed to care, didn't they? That part of the puzzle answered. Vern Lundquist along with Gary Danielson, Tracy Wolfson along in a moment. We know now that he's going to start. This was a tough, difficult decision for all.
Yeah, I think it was. I mean, it was a weird week all around. I came in Thursday for my normal practice. Gene Chizik has always been generous. Come in and watch. It was closed. And then our Friday meetings, we peppered him with 15, 20 questions, and we got no comment on anything. It was strange, and in fact, the main question, who was your starting quarterback on Friday, we got a no comment.
Yeah, there was a no comment from Chizik. And then we asked, is there any question about your quarterback? For which you will answer anything other than no comment. No comment. Cameron Newton. Cam Newton. Topic of so much innuendo, speculation. There was enough in the papers and on the internet to fill a bathtub. Let's go to Tracy, who's with Gene Chizik.
Thanks, Vern. Coach, we heard the public addresser announce Cam Newton's name. Officially, will he start today?
Oh, yeah. He's our quarterback today for Auburn University.
Why did this decision come down to a game-time decision?
Well, can't get into the particulars, but he's a quarterback today for Auburn University.
There's been a lot of distractions, obviously, surrounding this team. How have you handled it with them in terms of staying focused?
Really haven't had to do much, Tracy. We got a great class of seniors. They've been focused all week. They're ready to win this football game.
Thanks a lot. Good luck tonight. Vern, back to you.
Well, Gary, understandably, that's more than we heard Gene just say yesterday. Your reaction to what he just said.
Well, I think you got to look at the people involved here. I mean, these are honorable people that love Auburn, care about the SEC, and treasure college football. They really do. And I don't think this is an in-your-face emotional decision. I think this is thought out, and I think the word is fairness. And they decided to trust their people and go with this. But you know, the 2010 feel-good story around Cameron Newton has been almost a nightmare and kind of give you a peek inside. I mean, that's what I kind of do, try to take you down to the field. I go back to being on the elevator last night. I rode down the elevator with an old Auburn grad. He had his blue and orange on. He had his little, looked like his grandsons. And I go, you don't look happy. You're 10-0. And he says, you know, Gary, I just pray Auburn didn't do anything wrong. The doors open. The three of them said, War Eagle, and they went out on the night. I think that's what says about college football in the South. They love their game.
And there is indeed a game to be played. It's a game of consequence. In the West, Auburn can cinch a trip to Atlanta with a victory in this game against Georgia. That'll do it. They will go back to the SEC championship game. And on the other side, Georgia 5-5, trying to get bowl eligible. Gary, what do you expect from the Auburn team, knowing now that they've got Cam Newton for this
game?
Well,
more of the same, obviously. They've got a great player, probably the most valuable player in college football. But I think the real care that Auburn has to have is the rest of the guys don't stand around and wait for Cam Newton to make plays. Georgia's too good.
And what about Georgia coming in 5-5?
Georgia could have had it any better. They're 5-5, but there's no way they want to win this game without Cam Newton. They're happy they get to face Auburn at their best.
All right. This, as we said, is the 114th meeting. Georgia has won the last four. Look at the difference in total points scored. 1778 to 1722. First game played in 1892. Another beautiful day in the Deep South, 68 degrees. Winds are calm, the forecast for mostly sunny. Georgia won the toss, they have deferred, so Auburn will get the ball. Blair Walsh will kick off for the Bulldogs, and we are at long last underway. DeMond Washington, number 14. Gets to the 19, maybe the 20. Ladies and gentlemen, guess who's on the field? Shorten. Well, he's on the field. Cam Newton. From the 20, first down 10. Dodges the first tackler and the second. Now he's got a lot of room as he comes left. Knocked out of bounds after a 13-yard gain to the 33-yard line. Akeem Dent with the tackle flag down at the 35.
Yeah, this must have been some downfield blocking problem at the end of this play. One of the things about Cam Newton is you cannot go for the knockout blow on him. He is just too quick and he dodges him. You got to wrap him up.
On the defense, number 18. 15 yards to the end of the run. First down.
Heard the call from Hubert Owens, our referee today.
It was on Bakari Rambo that time. One of the two safeties that play for Georgia, one of their big hitters.
Ball is spotted at the 48-yard line. Left side. This is the freshman Michael Dyer. Little pirouette in the front of the linebacker, and he spins for an additional 3 yards and a first down 10. Dyer, fresh from a 180 outfit 2 weeks ago against Ole Miss.
Now you'll see Auburn start to speed it up. Near hash, after a couple first downs, they really try to go fast.
They'll try left guard this time. That's Dyer again, wearing number 5. Well, Cam Newton's numbers through 10 games, and in the most recent game, he did not play in the second half. 15 rushing touchdowns, 15 yards per completion. They are indeed gaudy statistics. Second down and 9. Ontario McCaleb is in the backfield behind Newton. Quick flip, near side. Terrell Zachary. Now let's take a look at the Auburn offense presented by Chick-fil-A. Zimba making his 49th start today. That equals an Auburn school record. Barry Pugh and the rest. Adam Smith, Dyer, Zachary, and Cody Burns, former quarterback at wide receiver, third down and 2.
Got both tackles to the right side now. Zimba and Mosley lined up to the right side right here. That's their power.
That's McCaleb in motion. And
that's the way they go.
Yeah. Look for the block from McCaleb. Here's Newton. Out of bounds at the 1 yard line.
When you talk to Gus Malzahn, he said one of our favorite formations has been bringing Zimba and Mosley, 73 and 75 together. Mike Berry pulls around, and you can see Cam Newton gets it turned upfield. He's just a monster.
At the goal line, ruled out of bounds. And will they review this? My guess is yes. Ruled out of bounds. It's under review.
We've got our camera set right on the goal line here. So if see if he crosses the plane. Of course, we can't tell from this angle whether his foot stepped out. The official's right on line there. He seems to see something touching the sideline. Let's see if he does. Boy, that's very close.
I don't think so.
That one could get overturned.
Here's the view from behind, Gary.
I think that's a touchdown. And, you know, never underestimate the importance of this. Remember, was it our first year or second year, Vern, that LSU game when they got it right down there against Florida and then they fumbled the very next snap? It was a huge play.
Another look from the low angle. This seems to be the most definitive. Now the pylon, his knee hits the pylon.
And the ball seemed to be inside the knee.
Yeah. That appears to be a touchdown.
Well, that was a nice drive. Five plays, four of them runs. That's one thing Georgia and Todd Grantham, their defensive coordinator, was afraid of. He said, there's no way we can simulate Cam Newton in practice.
Well, we're having a lengthy discussion. Retired referee Doyle Jackson is upstairs in the replay booth today.
You know what, if Vern, as we wait for this call, one thing I'm thinking of is I'm Aaron Murray over there, Georgia. I'm not surprised. I knew this was going to be a shootout. I mean, you're going to have to score, if you're Georgia, 35 points to win this game. You're only a freshman, but you got to know.
Now a flag has been thrown from the far side. Excuse me, Gary.
Don't see that every day.
I think Marcus Doughton was engaged in some conversation. That's Bakari Rambo.
It's not going to be a long penalty. Half the distance is about an inch.
We still don't have the call from Hubert Owen.
Now, the interesting thing is if it's a touchdown, then it obviously would be on the kickoff.
Right.
This is one thing about replay. They have to do it faster.
Yes.
It really just takes the air out of great plays. We see a great play there, and we're all waiting around for this.
And they're still huddling. Oh, goodness. Take another look at Cam Newton's run with a hold on. Here we are.
After further review, video evidence shows that the ball carrier broke the plane of the goal line, probably going out of bounds. Touchdown.
Run right at your two tackles. Best player in college football has the football.
Sportsmanlike conduct. Number 32 on the offense on the Auburn bench. That penalty will be enforced on the kickoff, 15 yards.
Well, Newton gets his 16th rushing touchdown of the year.
And Eric Smith got one on the bench.
On the bench. Backup H-back.
Wonder if he told the officials to hurry up with the call. No? We could get one.
Yeah, that took a while.
That's a big penalty, though, now. I mean, everybody knows it's a shootout type of game. They notified Gene Chizik first.
Well, Chizik is now talking to Eric Smith.
It's about how he talked to us on Friday, just like that.
Yeah, but that was a comment. LG, as a proud NCAA corporate partner, presents great SEC rivalries.
It's all about tailgating, flag waving, drink shaking, face paint.
Touchdown! Touchdown!
Kick top!
And it's gone! Oh, sweep it
up! SEC rivalries! It don't get no better than that! War Eagle!
There's so many lines there, and yeah. I'm just going to leave them all alone.
We got a three-hour game.
Yeah, you're right. First game played in 1892. And this is the tie for seventh oldest rivalry. There's Nova. Majestic bird, huh?
Well, in a strange way, I think the pressure of being number two in the country and an undefeated season was all focused on Cam all week. Obviously, Gene Chizik did a great job to get his team ready. Cam's going to play, and it looks like this team is not feeling the pressure of having to win this game to play for the West Championship or maybe play for the National Championship.
Well, they will kick off from the 15 after the penalty called on the bench, Eric Smith.
It's a big penalty.
Yes. Wes Byram will kick. Brandon Boykin, who has one 100-yard kickoff return this year, three 100-yard returns for kickoffs in his career, and four total for touchdowns. So he is a dangerous man once he gets the ball in his hands, and he's moved up to the 20-yard line. Here's Byram. That's a good one. That'll chase Boykin back to the 14-yard line. And he doesn't get much, does he?
He had no momentum when he caught that ball. He was actually going backwards when he caught it.
Jonathan Evans, number 35, is the guy who
got
there.
Watch Boykin. He actually takes a step back. He never got the top speed. That's a great cover for Auburn.
Josh Evans, a backup linebacker. And now on the field for the Bulldogs of Georgia, redshirt freshman Aaron Murray has improved game after game after game. Mark Richt, very, very happy with his quarterback. Chappis is the fullback. And Caleb King will open as the tailback. Play fake. Murray slips it out of the flat. It's a one-hopper to Caleb King. Now let's check the rest of Mark Richt's Georgia Bulldog offense presented by Chick-fil-A. Sturdivant, Glenn Jones, Bowling. He's there to contest Nick Fairley all afternoon. And Davis at right tackle. It's Green, Chappis. Ely was listed as the starter. Charles and Durham, the wideouts. Second and 10. King on the sweep left. He's got blockers in front. Breaks a tackle at the 38. And is hauled down by Craig Stevens. But watch the block. of Cordy Glenn.
Well, you can talk about Auburn's outstanding offensive line, but Georgia's offensive line are veterans and doing a wonderful job, too. I mean, their record doesn't show it, but this Georgia offense is putting up points and has really found themselves once they got number 8 back, A.J., because, you know, really, he's the second most valuable player in this league is A.J.
Saw the graphic, 5 consecutive games, 30 points plus. Murray is hit, and then he is dropped after he's hit a second time. Nosa Igwe got there. Not a sack master. That's his first full sack of the season for Igwe.
Well, usually you put your eyes on number 90, Nick Fairley. He's got a couple guys looking at him. Get a rush from the outside that by time by Darren Bates, and that really forced Aaron Murray up in the pocket for the sack.
Loss of 7, 2nd and 17. Murray, man open, caught. Orson Charles, his high school teammate, and the starting tight end for the Bulldogs. They were teammates at Plant High School in Tampa, where they won a state championship. Carter Clayton Fairley, who's making an All-American move this year. Igwe had the last sack. Next up, Stevens, Bynes, and Bates, who's been out a couple of weeks with an injury. And the secondary, Washington Etheridge, McNeil, and Nico Thorpe. Ted Roof, defensive coordinator, 3rd and 3. Blitz, crossing pattern. Inside, A.J. Green, first down at the 40.
Well, I tell you, Nick Fairley on that quick pass was right in Murray's face. But outside, A.J. Green gets inside so easily from Bell that time. And Murray just does a great job, Aaron does. He gets pressure. And, boy, that's the play that a few coaches have told. Oh, it looks like they got their helmets stuck on that play. The face masks were stuck. A couple coaches have told me they believe that Nick Fairley is driving the quarterbacks into the ground and to be aware of it.
First down, Caleb King. A little bit of a struggle at left tackle. He picks up a yard, maybe a yard and a half. And a flag is down. Thrown on the far side near the 32.
After the play was over, personal foul on the defense number 14. After the play was over, personal foul on the offense number 12. Those penalties canceled. The play stands, it'll be second down.
Well, Tavares King is number 12 for Georgia. And DeMond Washington, Mark Richt, is going to get in King's face.
Yeah, and Mark is saying, listen, you had the penalty. We had 15 yards. If you don't retaliate, we're going to be 15 yards closer to
yep.
the goal line.
With Sean Ely is on the field for the first time now. We'll see him and Caleb King throughout the afternoon. Play action. Oh, boy. Murray is still upright. Bates missed it, and Murray throws it away.
That was a big play.
Devin Bates had him wrapped up and did not secure the tackle.
It's the second time Bates has come from the outside as a linebacker, come off the edge. Watch him, unblocked on a bootleg play, which makes sense. On those type of bootleg plays, the quarterback is assigned to the outside linebacker. And Aaron Murray did a great job of getting rid of it, basically made a 10-yard gain by not losing the 10 yards.
Now the Bulldogs have a 3rd and 9. 3 wide right, 1 split left. Quarterback draw goes left. close. I don't believe he got enough.
Yeah, but this is obviously from the call. This is four down territory. They know, I believe, Mark Richt feels that Auburn is going to put points on the board, and he's going to have to convert some fourth down plays in this game.
That was Bashaun Ely and Nico Thorpe trying to make the tackle. And it appears that Georgia will go for the first down.
Uh-oh. That might be too many men in the huddle. They're going to have to take a timeout.
Yep. And they do. A.J. Green suddenly realized he was the not-so-odd man out, and he needed to get out of there. But they got the call in time.
Look it over here. Coaches are going, we got too many. And right away a timeout to save the five-yard penalty.
First timeout taken by Georgia. Fourth and two when we come back to Auburn. The Home Depot SEC on CBS is sponsored by Macy's, Verizon, K Jewelers, and by Dr. Pepper. Georgia ball at the 31-yard line. Fourth down, a little more than one. Sean Chappas is the fullback, number 49. And Ely is the running back.
Yeah. You know, Georgia in the past likes to slip their fullback out in the flat on these type of plays. That's a long yard and a half. Let's see if they try to slip the fullback out in the flat.
Fullback wears number 49. He's the short man in the eye. Orson Charles goes up tight to the left side. Now comes in motion. Play fake, Murray. Lot of time, deep. A.J. Green, touchdown, Georgia.
I don't think that was the fullback. I just got a...
I was about to congratulate you for your astute analysis.
Well, I got the pass part right. Hey, you know you need points. You know you got a great player. Might as well give it to him, huh?
Well, A.J. Green all but undressed Damon Washington, number 14 for Auburn on the play.
Yeah, I think he felt he had help back here from a safety. Here's Damon Washington one-on-one right there. Let's see what happens. He feels he's got a safety. Where did the safety go? Oh, just bit over the middle on the play that time, and they got an easy one. You got number two, we got number eight. That's a good matchup.
It has been, as we said, a tumultuous 10 days in the life of Cam Newton. Let's take you through the timeline. November 1st, week ago Thursday, first allegations of a pay-to-play scenario. On the 6th, Newton threw four touchdowns at Chattanooga, said, "I did nothing wrong." Next development came on the 9th, allegations that Cam was involved in academic fraud at Florida and faced expulsion. There was more in the drama. Coach Gene Chizik and athletic director Jay Jacobs defended Newton very emotionally, insisted that he would be the starting quarterback today. On the 10th, Mississippi State confirms contacting the SEC regarding Cam Newton. On the 12th, Cecil Newton allegedly admitted that he asked for money without Cam's knowledge. And here we are. There was a council among the Auburn Athletic Department. We were told that the NCAA was part of the conversation, and a very conscious decision to have Cam Newton play in this game this afternoon. And here comes Damon Washington. He's out to the 27. And for more on Cam Newton, here's Tracy Wolfson.
Well, guys, Auburn's 1985 Heisman Trophy winner Bo Jackson on the sideline right before kickoff. He went up to Cam Newton, gave him a big hug, and reminded him to stay focused. He's been very involved on the sideline so far, giving some advice to several players, especially after that last drive, guys.
All right, thank you, Tracy. That news update was for the benefit of all of those who might have been stuck on a dead-in-the-water cruise ship south of San Diego and didn't know about Cam
Newton. Aren't you afraid of doing that? I can't believe you're going to do that.
Oh, I'm going to do it forever and ever.
Keep my feet on the ground.
First down and 10. A little handoff out to the 31-yard line. 7-7 ball game. Murray getting some medical attention over on the Georgia sideline. And now a jersey change. You can see he's got the
chin. Remember, Hudson Mason, a true freshman, is his backup. And Nick Fairley is going to the locker room, by the way.
He sure is. Heading south. Newton. They slipped it to the right side. It's Ontario McCaleb. And McCaleb can flat fly. Little nifty ball handling. There is, however, a flag back at the 35.
It's coming back. I got a feeling here that Cam Newton practiced all week, because this takes a lot of practice. Look at the timing here. It's basically the Statue of Liberty play.
Yep.
Boise State did it. Watch, they're going to throw it one way and slip it the other way at the same time. Got holding outside. I believe it was on Brandon Mosley right there.
Holding. Offense. Number 75. That penalty is 10 yards from the spot of the foul. Second down.
Well, that wipes out a 40-yard gain by McCaleb. And a moment ago, as we mentioned, Fairley going to the locker room.
Yeah, and he has to get back out on the field. They were checking his shoulder when I was looking at him on the bench down there, and then he runs in. He's, I think, their second most important player on the field.
Second down and 12 after the penalty on Mosley. Nothing there.
Great job that time.
Justin Houston, who is having a terrific season for Georgia, made the tackle. More flags down. Getting a little chippy, I think.
And I tell you, it's being led by Mark Richt.
And we'll go through the lineups presented by Chick-fil-A. Here's Gamble, Dent, Robinson, and Houston. Cummings, Ogletree, Rambo, and Boykin.
Had my eye on Mark Richt all through
personal
this game.
Foul. Number 57 on the offense, unnecessary roughness. That penalty is 15 yards from the end of the run. Third down.
And Mark has been very animated on the sidelines about penalties, about his defense. That's his most involved. I really got the feeling he thinks his team is, as he told us, it's much better than their record, obviously, right, but that they can win this football game and make something out of this season.
That penalty was called on the right guard. You might think of it as Byron Isom. He pronounces it Baron.
He headbutted as he got up out of the stance and headbutted. Watch this. See the headbutt? Right there.
Here's Newton back. Deep across the middle. That one
dropped.
Intercepted. Picked up by Bakari Rambo, number 18. Newton picked off. There's also a flag down. He is all the way down to the 1 yard line. There is a flag in the backfield.
Yeah, I think it's going to be holding on Auburn, though, and it's not going to come back.
73 on the offense. That penalty is declined. The result of the play stands.
Well, you can't throw a football any better than this, but as we talked about in the open, you're going to see the squaring come right across, right in the middle. It's a well-thrown ball. But there's a little bit of nerves going on. Emery Blake right through his hands. And you know what I've talked about is when you have a great player, you get the feeling like, well, with Cam, we can't lose. And that's not the case. This league is much too tough.
Rambo with the interception. He is ruled to have stepped out of bounds at the 9, where Georgia has it first and goal.
And Nick Fairley can't be out there.
Caleb King is the running back, deep back in the eye. Play action, Murray. Deep in the middle, got him open. Touchdown. Sean Chappas, there's your fullback.
I was one play early. They love to throw the fullback. And what did Mike Bobo tell us? We love the matchups. We think we have some big plays against these guys.
One turnover, one play. Georgia touchdown. Walsh with the extra point. Cuts it inside the left upright. Cam Newton picked off by Bakari Rambo to set up this play.
That's just too easy. Even Ari Murray said, I haven't seen many that easy in this league.
Now it's time to look at our Home Depot tools for success.
There's different ways to use a great player. Here's Green right here. Now watch it. Two receivers attract three defenders. And what that means is the fullback is matched up on the linebacker. You run a play action pass right at him. The linebacker takes a step in. Easy touchdown. That's how you design plays. That's why those coaches stay there till 10:30, 11, 12 at night. Perfect call from Mike Bobo.
Is that why you're not in coaching?
Well, yes. I don't know. Maybe I couldn't get along with everybody either.
From
that
the
was
30.
Nice, though. Wasn't that nice?
Yeah, it was.
Not if you're an Auburn fan, but if you're a fan of football and design and good coaching, that's a well-executed play.
Just see that graphic. Last year, Georgia, minus 16 in turnovers. And they have completely turned it around, if you don't mind. And they're plus 8 for the year now. Here's DeMond Washington at the 15. And he does manage to reach the 25-yard line. For more on Nick Fairley's circumstance, here's Tracy.
Guys, Nick Fairley just came running out of the locker room. As you mentioned, a right shoulder injury. Renowned doctor, Dr. James Andrews, on hand checking him out. They added some extra padding underneath that right shoulder pad. They do expect him to go back in.
I think that's a play when he drove his shoulder into the ground pursuing on that third down play.
First down 10. Auburn trailing 14-7 midway through quarter number one. Cam Newton, question mark as to whether he would start in the last 36 hours. And he did start, as you know. Here's McCaleb going right. Gene Chizik, very emotionally on Wednesday, said he is our starting quarterback. And then it was really an unusual week because I'm sure after a conference with all the athletic department officials, athletic director Jay Jacobs, I'm sure the president, they decided to go into what Tony Barnhart called a lockdown mode. No comment was the operative phrase around here for the last 2.5 days. Second down. Newton. Got it. At the 30, it'll be third down. That was Justin Houston.
The SEC sack leader, Justin Houston. And what Georgia has, I think that Auburn noticed on tape, is speed. Top to bottom, this Georgia defense probably runs as well as any defense, probably on a par with LSU.
Third and 5. Darvin Adams is the wide receiver to the left. Two others top right. Mario Fannin comes out. Here's Newton back to throw. Now he'll take off. Stiff arm. First down.
He better be careful on that one. And he got warned.
That looked like more like a right jab.
It was unnecessary, too. Cam does a good job. No pressure from the Georgia defense right here. And Cam needs to be very careful. That is a 15-yard penalty. I bet the next one is. That's my bet.
14-yard gain, and it stands. On first down, here's Newton. Play action goes deep left side. Fannin is there. And he drops it.
I'll tell you, Auburn is a tight football team. They've had two personal fouls, a big holding call, now two drop passes. One led to a touchdown. This would have been a touchdown. That's a 14-point turnaround. Remember, the holding penalty was a huge call coming down the sideline.
That wiped out a 40-yard gain. Second down and 10. McCaleb darts to the right, has to circle back, and it's going to be third and 11 or 12, depending on the spot.
That was well defended by Georgia. Todd Grantham, their defensive coordinator, talked to him on phone and on the field, and he said, you must know what each formation, the weapons and the plays they can run. You got to divide up the offense. You can't try to defend everything against all their formations. You got to divide it up.
Third and 11, four wideouts, one running back. Four-man rush, little screen to Fannin, got it. But he's going to be caught short of the first down as Mario Fannin reaches the 50-yard line. Bakari Rambo makes the tackle, and the punting unit will come on. This has been an area where Gene Chizik has expressed his displeasure. He's gone back and forth with two punters this year. He's got Ryan Shoemaker, a senior, who started the season. Then he gave way to Stephen Clark, and now it's Shoemaker who's back on there. Logan Gray back to return it. This is a good one. Gray will let it bounce.
Oh, he missed it. That's three big plays. That's a 20-yard play again.
To Charvin Bell, number 22, right in his mitts.
This is going to be on the 1 or 2 yard line. My goodness. Auburn can feel the pressure. You know, the pressure doesn't start till November. We've seen this year after year in college football. These teams that are ranked up at the top can just feel it. I thought that first drive signified that they were ready.
Yeah.
They're ready, but so is Georgia.
From the 20 and a 7-point lead, first down and 10. Aaron Murray, bandaged chin and all, blitz coming from the corner, but they break through it. It's Ely out to the 30 and perhaps a little more. Let's go back to the studio for this John Hancock update.
Vern, I've got a super fly in the ointment alert underway. Andy Dalton, the TCU quarterback, is going to be hit by Rob Andrews of San Diego State. He fumbles. It's recovered by Jerome Long in the end zone. They reviewed it. It's a touchdown. The Aztecs up 14-0, though it's early. Back to you.
Think there's any interest in what's going on there in Boise State after they demolished Idaho last night, huh?
Yeah, that's another one of those great second-year coaches, Brady Hoke at San Diego State, doing a great job there.
Fairley's back on the field. Here's Murray, play fake. Again, he's got all kinds of time.
One team's making the catches and one team isn't.
Well, one team has A.J. Green and the other doesn't.
It's about as bad as you can throw a crossing route.
Fairley got to Murray again. Here's Fairley, number 90.
Yeah, let's see if he drives him into the ground again. That's what at the end of the play, but you could see A.J. Green makes a nice play. Let's see if he drives him into the ground. See, that's the play.
Yeah.
The NFL really has cleaned that up. College football needs to address that play.
Now, we asked Ted Ruth, the defensive coordinator, point blank, you did, had he been notified by the league of complaints from other coaches? And he said no. Here's Ely. And Ely scoots down the sidelines and out of bounds.
It's another mistake by Auburn. They did not align well. This was a gimme first down. Look at the edge here. No one outside playing the edge. No one to set the edge. Georgia has the perfect play on. Josh Bynes is trying to get his guys loaded up. This is a 10-yard sprint in touch football. Auburn making way too many mistakes early.
Josh Bynes, one of the leaders defensively, has been adamant about their lack of prowess in securing tackles. And he was the guy who missed one then. First down, play fake again. Murray, deep right side. A.J. Green, DeMond Washington.
Oh.
Easy touchdown. Easy touchdown.
nudge by AJ Green there.
There was that.
Let me put it this way. It was a professional nudge right there. That's how the guys do it in the big leagues, right there.
Damon Washington was defending, and for the second time, A.J. Green wins the battle.
He underruns the ball, means he knows the ball's in front of him, so he waits and watch the subtle nudge. Little nudge, and then go get it.
Aaron Murray threw it. 21-7. NFL on CBS regional coverage tomorrow. Cincinnati, Indy, the lead game early. Jets at Cleveland. Tennessee, Miami, Houston, Jacksonville. And then the late game, Kansas City at Denver. That's the NFL lineup tomorrow. And it all begins with JB and the guys. The NFL today at 12 noon Eastern time tomorrow on CBS. Well.
Oh, yeah. I'm telling you, Georgia can play with anyone. And had they beaten Florida, with South Carolina's loss, they'd be playing to play in the SEC East in Atlanta.
Now Mark Richt
is still sick about that,
yeah,
right?
Yeah, he was telling us in a phone conversation on Friday, he knew what was at stake in the loss to Florida. Well, Georgia, an explosive opening quarter, 21 points. Mentioned that offensively they've scored 30 points plus in the last five games. Here's Blair Walsh. Damon Washington, number 14. And let's take another look at A.J. Green's touchdown catch. Flag is down.
Let's take a peek on the bottom right-hand part of the screen right there. Watch the arm extend. Watch it back and forth. Arm extend. A.J. Green. Now, usually if you want to get away with this, you have to kind of push with your elbow. See that extended arm? That was enough that Devin Washington had no chance for this one. It was well played, and A.J. ran through the ball, which is exactly what you're supposed to do. Not run past it and turn around. He judged it beautifully.
Four catches already.
During the return, illegal block in the back. Number 23 on the kicking team. That penalty is 10 yards from the end of the run. First down.
Jakar Hamilton is the fella guilty of the foul. Auburn trailed by 17 points earlier in this season. They came from behind to defeat Clemson. They were down 13 in their win against South Carolina.
But you know what's not on that graphic? Not when they were the number two team in the country and all the pressure was on them.
We will see how they will respond. We've still got 53 seconds to go, opening quarter. Newton led them on an opening drive touchdown. It was like a knife through butter. They just zipped down the field. Here's Newton. Got him.
Nothing.
Avery Jones, number 93.
Jones substituted in the Florida game. He did not start, came in, did a good job in that football game. Three tackles, but on this one, it looks like the Georgia front five, the outside linebackers and the three inside guys, are winning so far.
Second and 12. Now they look over at the Auburn bench. Gus Malzahn.
See, no hurry here. He wants to give his defense a rest until he gets a first down.
Handoff, breakthrough. Michael Dyer. That looked like it was going to be a bunch more.
Tell you, Hakeem Dent and Marcus Doughton are doing a nice job inside, too. Hakeem Dent is a tackling machine. Doughton was all over that one also.
Auburn led 7-0, 21 unanswered. Two touchdown catches by A.J. Green from Aaron Murray. We'll return to Jordan-Hare Stadium after this message and a word from your local station. We welcome you back to Jordan-Hare Stadium on the campus of Auburn, Alabama. Georgia comes into town, this much anticipated game, and they grab control with 21 points in the first quarter. Vern Lundquist, Gary Danielson, Tracy Wolfson, our entire CBS crew here in Auburn. Third down, 8. Time for Newton across the middle, tipped away.
Interference. It's going to be interference.
Cody Burns. That's 18 on 18. Bakari Rambo and Cody Burns. And take a look, Gary, as he comes from the right side.
On this play, Georgia had a spy, so Cam Newton had plenty of time to throw and a little bit too aggressive on the play for the Georgia defensive back.
Pass interference. Defense number 18. The ball is placed at the spot of the foul. The penalty carries an automatic first down.
Rambo saying, who, me?
Yeah, you. That's what it called.
Yep.
And now after a first down, I think you'll now try to see the up-tempo game.
Ontario McCaleb is alongside Cam Newton. They have moved just across the 50. 21-7 Georgia. Got off to a 1-5 start, now at 5-5. Newton nailed. Well, with Darryl Gamble's tackle, the frustration continues now for Auburn. You know, it just seems to me, with all that's been going on for a week and a half, that we should be in the fourth quarter.
It does seem like that, because the anticipation of coming to the stadium,
right?
Will he play? Watch him. I actually think that's the way Auburn feels in this football game. They're almost out of gas. They're so emotionally into the game. They haven't caught their second wind yet.
Up the middle, Newton. Let's go back to New York. Here's Tim Brennan.
Back to you.
Oh, yeah.
All right, Tim, thank you. Third down and 1. Here's Newton, 5 yards back. He'll take it at right tackle, spins. First down at the 35, and a quick mid-course correction. I said Georgia started 1-5. It seemed like that to them. They started 1-4, and then they got A.J. Green. He came back. Remember, A.J. Green sat out 4 games with a NCAA-imposed suspension. But 5-5 now. Came back in their 4th loss in a row. That was to Colorado.
Of course, quick snap here.
Here we go. Got it. Toss. McCaleb trying to turn the corner. Can't quite. Well, Georgia, A.J. Green suspended because he sold a jersey to an agent. Fessed up right away, said he knew when he completed the transaction he had made a mistake. He paid a 4-game suspended penalty. Their record without him, 1-3, with him, 4-2. And he gets to rest now. He's got 2 touchdown catches in this game. Got him. Blake, wow. First and goal. Got inside of Rambo. Emery Blake.
Well, Emery Blake had the early drop, but this about as good a throw as you can make as a quarterback. This is on a line. Watch this throw. 35 yards like a bullet. Holy cow, that should not be illegal. A guy can throw like that and run and be 6'6", 250.
McCaleb trying to get around the corner, does. Touchdown, Auburn.
Camera right on the line. Right over the line. That's that speed by Ontario McCaleb and the quick snap and the hurry up offense from Gus Malzahn's offense.
McCaleb weighs in at 167. Had the big tie breaking run of 70 yards in the win over LSU. 5 straight games with a rushing touchdown. Let's take a look at the 2 key plays in this drive.
Well, watch this throw. This is the one that everybody at the next level will say, ho, 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 ho. and then real quickly get up there, follow the pulling guard, and just outrun the defense to the corner. Power, arm, and speed.
It is a spectacular mid-November Saturday in the loveliest village on the plains, Auburn, Alabama. Aerial coverage of the SEC on CBS provided by MetLife. You know, we're very privileged, Gary, you, me, Tracy, our crew, travel throughout the SEC, and it's tough to decide favorite sites, isn't it?
It is for me. It's wonderful all over college football, especially at this time of year in the South. Ain't bad, though, I'll tell you that.
Well, this is on the short list, Auburn, Alabama. And it's been a very difficult week for them. There's just a plethora of accusations flying back and forth. And the decision made, as we will revisit throughout the afternoon, to play Cam Newton in this game and the next. Boykin back to return it from the 7. Wow, he got popped up near the 32-yard line by Tasharvin Bell, but for just that long, it looked like Boykin might be loose.
And he's the guy that returns touchdowns on kickoffs. One of the fastest players on Georgia's team, and he turns it up right here. I thought he had a crease, and Bell makes the play. Bell hits people better than he catches the ball, doesn't he?
True.
How about this for Georgia? 14 plays, 21 points.
Handoff. Caleb King out near the 39-yard line. Rode the back of Clint Bowling, number 60.
Well, Aaron Murray comes into this game as the other quarterback, right?
Right.
I mean, that was the story of my life. Okay, so right now he's 6 for 8 for 3 touchdowns. The other quarterback has shown up to play.
Well, you see the comparison. Newton 3 of 5 for 40 yards. Second down.
Wildcat.
And that's Brandon Smith, number 1. Brandon Smith, who in his career, now he missed 3 games with a concussion. He has been a starter for the Bulldogs at defensive back, wide receiver, running back, quarterback, and on special teams. He's a pretty good athlete. Third and 5. Green wide left. Murray looks the other direction. Now, he'll run near side and shovels it out of bounds. He was outside the tackle box. Josh Bynes was chasing him. No flag, but there is a 4th down.
Well, once he's out of the tackle box, he knows.
It's legal.
All he has to do is get it across the line of scrimmage there. And it's a positive play. I mean, this kid thinks, as for a freshman, I mean, Mark Richt could not stop raving about him.
Now Quindarius Carr is back to return Drew Butler's punt. Butler, number 1 in the country last year with a 48.5 average. He's in the top 5 this year, up above 45. Fair catch. Carr backs up, grabs it at the 13-yard line.
How far was that one?
We're going to know in a second. 48 yards.
You know, almost half of his punts have gone for more than 50 yards. That was a bad one for Butler. Only 48 yards.
Puny. We'll continue after this word from your local station.
A 315-horsepower, 5.3-liter V8. 21-highway MPG. 20-inch wheels, and a heart of chrome. The GMC Sierra Z60.
Now get $6,500 total value when you finance with Ally. And get a 2011 GMC Sierra Z60 for $30,300.
Every day you face financial choices, large and small. When you make the right choices, you head in the right direction. At BB&T, we've spent more than 135 years sharing our knowledge, helping clients become more informed in all areas of their financial lives. With our checking and savings options and online and mobile banking, it's easier than ever to find the direction just right for you. Talk to us today about your banking needs and know how it feels to know more. BB&T.
You're watching the Gulf Coast News Leader, WKRG News 5.
It has been a long 10 days for the commissioner of the SEC, Mike Slive. In conversations with John Solomon of the Birmingham News and with our Tony Barnhart, Commissioner Slive had this to say about the Cam Newton status. The only thing we made clear to Auburn is a decision about his eligibility is a decision that has to be made by the institution. And he added this: I hope that people will reserve judgment in fairness to the SEC, in fairness to the institutions, and most importantly, in fairness to the young man. I hope people will exercise thought and patience before making those decisions. I'm concerned about fairness, and this has to do with fairness.
Couldn't agree more.
Yep.
Especially the last part. Everything involved. Everyone involved. The schools, the conference, and college football, but most importantly for the Cam Newtons. Truth will come out eventually.
First down and 10. 10:43 to go. Newton has a man open. That's Terrell Zachary, number 81. They move it 5-6 yards out to the 20-yard line in front of Brandon Boykin.
You know what's interesting about Gus Malzahn's tutelage of Cam Newton is against the easiest teams, he decided not to run them. He got a lot of throwing in, and you can see now in a tough game when he's not able to run for a lot of yards so far, his passing has improved so much. It's paying off for the Auburn Tigers.
4 out of 6 for 47 yards.
And one big drop right in the hand.
Oh, yes, that was Mario Fanny.
Maybe 2. That's right, earlier.
Mm-hmm.
Look at that.
Whoa! Little polish on that one. That's Darvin Adams. Mm-hmm. Well, we've seen a variety of miscues from Auburn in this one.
Remember, Emery Blake had the early drop for the touchdown, but Cam Newton had the interception on a perfect throw. One of those two drop passes, a holding penalty, personal fouls. Then they botched the punt inside the 1 yard line.
First down and 10. Newton keeps it.
That one didn't look right.
It looked like a broken play.
Yeah, it did, didn't it?
Maybe Dyer and Newton misconnected.
This was just a power play out of the spread. Watch the pulling guard come across and kick out. Let's see if the ball should have gone to Dyer. Yeah, he got a little confused there. That just didn't feel and look right. They got a positive play out of it.
Second down and 5. And Georgia stops him. It'll be 3rd down 2, perhaps. Akeem Dent, who leads this Georgia team in tackles. There's number 51. Came into this one with 94 tackles. So he's, barring injury, certain to go over 100 again this year. 3rd down 2.
Nice late sub there by Georgia. Not panicking at all.
3 down defensively. They bring 3. Cover over the left side. Here's Newton in trouble. Got him.
I'm telling you, give that one to Todd Grantham. Late before the snap, he brought on an extra defensive back, and I think he outwitted that Auburn offense. Keontae Tripp, number 31, I think, is the guy that finished it. Auburn on short yardage brings receivers out. A late matchup brings an extra DB, only a 3-man line, and Keontae Tripp kind of cleans it up. Nobody open on the play.
And so 4th down now. Brandon Smith is back, calls for the fair catch, takes it at the 35-yard line. Among those who was involved in that tackle was Keyonte Tripp, who today is wearing number 31 in honor of Quentin Banks. Each week, a different member of the Bulldog team wears 31 for Quentin Banks, who had to give up his career with knee injuries. This guy was a high school classmate of Cameron Newton's. Watch Fantasy Football today to get the last minute news and analysis you need to set up your fantasy league lineup. It's live every Sunday at 11 a.m. Eastern, only on CBSSports.com. 7:45 to go before the half. Georgia, 17 plays, 21 points.
How about that bottom one, though? 8 plays of more than 10 yards.
Right side, Ealy cuts back. And time now, as we do weekly, to introduce the Duck.
Aflac!
And ask the Aflac trivia question of the week. Which coach has the most wins in the Georgia-Auburn series? And it's 114 games, including this one, that have been played. Gene Chizik in his second as a head coach. 3 years as a defensive coordinator here. On second down. Flag is down. It's a first down if the play stands, but the flag came from the umpire. And that usually means in this circumstance, this thing is going to go south.
Well, Auburn was almost daring Georgia to throw the ball on that second down play. They had 9 players near the line of scrimmage.
It's going to go south, but not all that far.
Personal foul, chop block.
Oh.
On the offense, number 78. That penalty was 15 yards from the previous spot. Second down.
Josh Davis.
I think it's going to be on fairly. Let's see who gets him. Engage and hit. Oh, yeah, that's
oh,
one.
Yeah.
Engaged by Bowling and then a throw by Josh Davis. And I really applaud the officials for calling that one. That is the dangerous one for those defensive linemen.
Second down, 17. Georgia in the eye. Murray throwing the ball to 6 of 9 for 121 yards. He launches deep. He's got a man open.
Oh, look at that.
How about that? That is going to be about a yard short of the first down. It's A.J. Green again.
And he got hit by our Mr. Nick Fairley just as he let it go. Fairley's favoring that right shoulder. A.J. Green blanked out to the right. Let's see the route. Comes off. Not enough of a jam. Not even a straight cut to the inside. Just too fast and a perfect throw. Watch Nick Fairley. His lands right on his right shoulder. So both the two guys that are injured, both of them, take one on that one.
Third and one.
Look at the split on this play.
Look at the keep. Murray around the corner. And he's got a first down at the 50. That gives us a chance to go back to Tim Brando in New York.
All right, Vern, back to Amon Carter in Fort Worth. We said it was early, and Andy Dalton knows that. He hits Logan Brock with a 15-yard strike. The extra point was missed. San Diego State still up by 1, 14-13. Back to you.
Okay, Tim, thank you. First down at the 50.
That was an odd formation. Let's look for that one later if they might have something tied up to that.
Play fake. Nobody open. Good coverage by Nico Thorpe down the right side.
It was only a 2-man route that time. When you keep your tight end and both of your backs in, it's pretty easy to cover those guys down the field.
That was Tavares King, who was the intended receiver. And it brings up second down and 10. 5:15 to go. Georgia has won the last four games in this series. So no Auburn senior has ever won against the Bulldogs in their career here. Caleb King got him. Third down. Mick Fairley, Corey Lemonnier, number 55. Fairley having an All-American season.
He absolutely is. Drake Nevis from LSU says, thank you, Nick Fairley, because your great play inspired me to have a great one the next week. This is a must stop for Auburn. Remember, Georgia has the ball, Georgia has the lead, and Georgia gets the second half kickoff.
Third and 10. Flag. Might not have gotten the play called in time.
Before the snap, false start. Ah. 7-1 on the offense. The penalty is 5 yards from the previous spot. Third down.
Well, if Cam Newton's the most valuable player in the SEC, A.J. Green might be the second most valuable player in this conference. He glides, he catches, he juggles, he shoves off. Ah. But he judges the ball perfectly.
Third and 15. He's top of your screen, and Nico Thorpe is playing well back. Little inside pass is incomplete. Looks like it was intended for Caleb King, and Mike Blanc, number 93, got in there to mess things up. Fourth down.
Well, that was a great defensive stand by Auburn. Got a little help with the penalty play to make it third and very long, but they had to have that stop. Be very interested now how Gus Malzahn handles this four-minute clock. He does not want to give the ball back to Georgia.
Drew Butler is on the punt.
Not a great one.
No, and it takes an Auburn bounce.
Pick it up and run with it. It's free ball if you're Auburn. Once Georgia touches the ball, Auburn can pick it up freely and run with it and have no consequences.
Didn't. Now it's going to be spotted, it appears, at the 26. That's officially, it's called a 28-yard punt. Well, there's the touch. Here's Gamble. All right, Tim, I thought that might have been a misprint. 83 points. Well, time now to answer the Aflac trivia question. Which coach has the most wins in Georgia Auburn series history? I got this one wrong. Shook Jordan, 15. Assistant coach at Georgia in 46-50, and then head coach here. A lot of great coaches have dual identities. Here's Vince Dooley, Auburn and Georgia head coach, and Pat Dye, the Georgia guard from 58-60, and the head coach here, 81-92. Gene Chizik, 0-2 against Mark Richt's team. Mark Richt was talking with us Friday about the biggest win in his 10 years in Georgia, and it came here 2002 as David Green and Michael Johnson hooked up on a touchdown on a 4th and 15 from the 19. Here's a quick flip, and the Bulldogs won that one 24-21 and won the SEC championship for that night. Here we go, 3:37. What do you expect from him?
I think that they're going to try to take clock and at least get it under the two-minute mark before they really look at that. They are taking their time. This is not the hurry up. Oh, I tell you, this Georgia defense is playing.
That's Akeem Dent, number 51.
Trying to run power isolation inside, runs behind the block that time. Actually, he didn't stay with Eric Smith. If the running back would have stayed with Smith, I think he would have picked it up. Poor Reed.
Out of the spread on third and one.
Last time in third and short, they passed. I don't see it this time. I think they're going to run the ball.
With Newton. And he's got the first down at the 40-yard line.
Remember last time Vernon was at third and a yard and a half? And
yes.
Had the matchup. You know, you got an Auburn team that's averaging over 300 yards rushing a game in the SEC, and they call a pass play on third and short, which surprised me, and Todd Grantham had them dialed in.
Auburn does have all three timeouts remaining. First down 10 with 2:24 to go before the break. Newton with the play fake to McCaleb. Deep left side, wide open.
But he caught. He threw that flat-footed. Oh, my goodness.
Emery Blake on the cut was open by 5 yards. That's a 25-yard gain.
Yeah, all the way across the field. Newton flat-footed just lets this thing go at the last second. Play-action pass, rips it. He didn't even step into that throw. It was a wonderful route by Blake, and now the whole offense is there. And Gus Malzahn says, once I get over the 50, I have what I call landmark plays. I know where I want to call my plays from where I am on the field.
Here's one of them. Reverse, Cody Burns, former quarterback.
Throw it away.
But nobody open.
There it is.
And he throws it away. He was the starting quarterback in this game 2 years ago.
And this was handled well by the Georgia defense. Trick play on first down, nothing.
And so, 1:50 to go, second down and 10.
Cannot help but be impressed with Georgia's advancement on defense. They're so much more solid. They know where to line up than they did a year ago when I was watching them.
Well, of course, they made 3 defensive coaching changes this year. There's the perfect pass to Fannin, but a nice open field tackle at the 32.
Yeah. I mean, look, that was a well-executed play. What'd they get, 2 yards?
Yes. Well, last year, Georgia's defense, they let go of 3 coaches headed by Willie Martinez, the defensive coordinator. These are the numbers on your left last season, on your right. This is in the SEC. Now third down. Todd Grantham came in to take Willie Martinez's place, and they went to a 3-4.
Mark Richt's going to take a timeout here.
And it comes with 1:14 remaining in the half.
Doesn't look like he wanted the timeout, did he, right there? He was like saying something to the official that you misunderstood me, it looked like to me.
Coming up at the half, the Geico halftime report. We're going to go back to our New York studios. Tim and Spencer are there, but we're blessed with the presence of Mr. Tony Barnhart. So he's going to have an update. We're going to move out of the way and let Tony take over this spot. Coming up with the Geico halftime report. Third down and 8.
It's a 50-yard field goal if they gain nothing. I would bet this ball stays on the ground. I don't know. Cam's earned the right to throw it. I will say that. But they could force Georgia into the last timeout if they don't make it.
Georgia bringing 3. Newton has it. Little stutter step. Newton first down at the 20.
That's never a bad call.
He's a weapon, isn't he?
Yes, he is.
Yeah, keep it on the ground.
Yeah, keep it on the ground. The clock is going to start. Auburn has all 3 timeouts. If you don't make it, you're going to move it forward for a field goal try. And if you do, you have plenty of time.
Well, Newton is now thrown for 93, and he's gained 90 on the ground. Gives it off to McCaleb to start Mario Fanning. And now, again, Auburn with all 3 timeouts left, 56 seconds to go.
You know who's been quiet is Michael Dyer. I really thought we would see a lot of Dyer in this game, and we have not seen much start up. Well, he is on the bench, and he's being looked at, it looks like, to me. Not catched what happened to Dyer. I thought we would see a lot of Dyer in this game. There he is.
four carries so far for only 19 yards. Time called. Cam Newton, the starting quarterback today. He's thrown for 93 and rushed for 90.
Yeah, he has started out, remember, in this football game, scramble early, then that run down the sideline for the touchdown to make it 7-0. Then they started to go through the air. Great pass, dropped by Blake, that actually produced a score for Georgia, but then look at this throw. That's about as good as you can do. Now it seems that Newton is quiet, but he has 90 rush yards. And remember, that includes 2 sacks for minus 10. Michael Dyer, by the way, is back in the football game.
Wearing number 5 at second down and 8. Newton still has it. Drills it in the end zone.
Oh, my.
Caught. Touchdown. Philip Lutzen Kirken. I was hoping I'd get to say that today.
Ladies and gentlemen, this just is not that easy to do. This is another bullet by a guy that's rushed for 100 yards in the first half. Remember, he's had a couple sacks. Gus Malzahn says, you're a freak.
Lutzen Kirkin's third catch of the year for a TD. Wes Byram's extra point is up and good.
Now remember, he's rushed for, as Bo Jackson just gives him a handshake right there, he's rushed for 100 and he's 9 for 11 throwing with 2 drops.
And so the Auburn Tigers have come from 14 down and tied it at 21. Cam Newton out of Westlake High School, College Park, Georgia. 9 of 11, 111 yards, and a touchdown pass. He caught that one, put it in the arms of Philip Lutzen Kirken.
Lutzen Kirken had to catch that one. It would have gone right through him. Did you see the sign? Yes, we can, with Bo's picture on it right there.
Yep.
With Cam's picture. There we go. Yes, we can.
Wes Byram getting ready to kick off. 51 seconds to go. Georgia has one left. Auburn has 2. Brandon Boykin is the deep back, number 2 for the Bulldogs.
I'd love to be playing in this game.
Would you?
Yeah, Georgia's, this has got to be as fun as it can get if you're 5-5 and get to play against us. Perfect weather.
Boykin at the 3. Got and dropped at the 20, and let's revisit the touchdown.
We gave Mike Bobo an attaboy on a play call. Now watch this one. Watch the subtle roll by Cam Newton and what it does. It draws the safety over. Look how wide the safety is. The half roll produced the seam, and that's, again, a design by a coach to make that play. And you know what? Comes to the sideline, Bo knows talent.
Bo Jackson, one of 2 previous Heisman Trophy winners at Auburn University, the other being Pat Sullivan. Caleb King goes right. Oh, boy. Stevens, the linebacker, got him. Number 46 with help from Josh Bynes, number 17.
Watch Georgia 2 out of the last 3 weeks, and they have competed like mad. We asked Mark Richt, you know, it's such tough loss against Florida. Can you get your guys ready again? He goes, yes. I love this team, and it's a very good team, and we will show up and we will play.
Georgia has decided to save itself for the second half. They trailed by 7. They went up 21-7. Auburn came back, led by Cam Newton. And we have reached the halftime, 21-21, the undefeated and second-ranked Auburn Tigers against a 5-5 tenacious Georgia Bulldog team. Let's get on to Tracy with Gene Chizik.
Thanks, Vern. Coach, you started out slow. It seemed like a lack of focus with your team, and then the huge game-tying touchdown. So what was the difference in that half?
Well, I think early on, our whole team was really excited. They were, you know, we were making stupid penalties, giving up some deep plays. We turned the ball over early, which is unusual for us. We just had to get our team settled down, and they got to start playing.
Speaking of settling down, how about Cam and his focus after everything that's gone on this week?
Well, I think he's been really focused. You know, he's just got to continue to be more consistent in this game. We got to get him a few more runs, and he's got to be able to break a few more runs. But right now, we just got to be a more consistent team.
Thank you a lot.
Thank you.
All right, that's the end of the first half with our score 21-all. Now let's go to Tim Brando in our New York studio.
All right, Vern, thank you. Coming up on the...
Here's Newton.
The pocket throws wide open in the end zone. Touchdown. Touchdown, Auburn!
Well, that seems appropriate, does it not? As Nova looks on, we're tied at the half. 21-21. Moments ago, Tracy Wolfson with Mark Richt.
You jumped out to a 21-7 lead, but they were able to tie it to go into half. How did they get back in this game?
Well, they just made some stops on defense, and you know, they're a heck of an offensive football team. It's just a great football game right now. Good 30 minutes. Now we got to go finish.
A.J. Green, two touchdowns, 114 yards receiving. How has he been so successful so far?
Well, we've got some one-on-one matchups, and the one catch he had on fourth down was a situation that we thought we had a good shot at getting a one-on-one post and that type of deal. So Coach Bowe did a good job of installing the play, repping it, and then, you know, having the nerve to call it.
Thanks a lot. Good luck in the second half. Bird?
All right, Tracy, thank you. Anything you want to add to that?
Well, you know what kind of reminds me of a little bit is Mark Richt has a little bit of experience with this. He was the offensive coordinator for Florida State when they faced Michael Vick, a quarterback very much like Cam Newton, where they had to basically outscore them. He had Winkie and Peter Warwick. Remember those guys? He was calling play, so he can understand it's not going to be a lot of stops. You're just going to have to keep chucking it.
Well, that memorable game in the Sugar Bowl after the 1999 season. Third quarter. Boykin is back. A dribble kick onside.
Whoa.
Onside kick. Guess what? It worked.
How about that? Rolling the dice.
My gosh, how about that?
This is a Sean Payton call right here in the Super Bowl when they just rolled the dice and it worked.
Wes Byram kicked it off the top of the football, allowed it to go the 10 yards up and into his hands. I don't think there's any question that it went the necessary 10.
That was perfectly executed, wasn't it?
Now there is a player down. Gene Chizik is out. That's Chris Davis, a cornerback.
Let's see if we can see this on the right side of the screen. We're told number 11 right here. Oh, tries to stick his head in there. You can see he tries to get up and then can't. That's a good sign, though.
Yeah, sure is. Chris Davis, number 11.
Well, they've stolen a possession, has Auburn, haven't they?
How about that?
You only get about 12 or 13 a game, and they've stolen the first half. They had the first half, and now they've stolen the second half, opening drive.
And so a first down from the Auburn 41, and now
they are reviewing it.
Previous play is under further review.
What were they doing all that time?
I was just thinking that.
Well, that one is not going to show much there.
Nope.
Unless it was that eagle right there that was watching it.
All right, this is the replay you've already seen. Boom.
Does he touch it before it goes? Oh. Does his left hand touch the ball across the line? Right there. Does he help it across the line? Now remember, we don't have an angle right down the line, so we don't know. And it was called good on the field.
Right.
I don't see this one being overturned. I think I might have to apologize to the replay official. That's close enough to look. Especially if I bump into him in the elevator, too. You know? It's like a turnover, basically. You know, I mean, this is all half. George is going over first series. Here's what they're going to do. Does he touch it? Well, he actually grabs it. He doesn't look there like he helped it across.
Just a guess.
It's gonna.
Not enough evidence.
No way. I don't think so either.
How about that discussion in the locker room at halftime? Okay.
That's what I said. That was a
Sean Payton just called.
Yep, Sean Payton.
He said he's enjoying the game.
That's what I said. Only that was Super Bowl.
Really like to see you open the third quarter with an onside kick.
Remember, it's the 50, it's the 40 yard line.
After further review, the ruling on the field is confirmed. First down.
And so, that's a fairly pretty shot, isn't it? Looking west, obviously. Here's Chizik. Just a footnote. Wes Byram said, I knew it all along. First down and 10. It is indeed. Zachary coming around the left side, breaks a tackle, gets a block from Cody Burns, and that gives him an extra 10 yards.
Well, you start out with an onside kick and a reverse. Watch Cam gets a little block of the play. Again, well executed. Cam is right there to seal it. That's pretty easy. He's actually bigger than the defensive end.
Watch and Cody Burns, Gary.
Right, Cody there. Comes back at the end to clean it up. Yep. And then a quick snap, which is part of the game plan.
Michael Dyer doesn't get much. Well, he picked up a couple. There's another player down. This player for Georgia. Looks like it's DeMarcus Dobbs, number 58. Time has been taken, and we'll step away for a moment.
Here it is right here. DeMarcus Dobbs is going to fall into Brandon Mosley. His head gets jarred back. Not sure if it was Mosley, but you saw his head snap back, and it's good news that he walked off.
Yep. Looks like he's going to be just fine. Well, we're underway with the third quarter. I had this hard-nosed investigative question to ask you, like, what do you expect in the second half?
Yeah, right.
And we already know.
Well, you got two hot quarterbacks.
Right.
And then you've got a great player in A.J. Green and a great player in Nick Fairley. Seems to me the game is going to go right there. Can Fairley continue to dominate, or will A.J. Green continue to dominate? I think that could be the difference in the football game. I don't think Murray and Cam Newton are going to slow down.
Second down and 6. Well, officially call it 7. Here's Newton up the middle. That's going to be short of the first down, just inside the 20. Halftime trends.
Well, you see, we talked about Aaron Murray. I mean, out of those 7 out of 10, 12, Vern, I guess 3 of them he threw away. Cam Newton, 2 of them were dropped. That's only his passing. You remember he rushed, obviously, right there. And then A.J. Green. Auburn is going to be forced to double-team them, him. And then Auburn comes back, especially that last touchdown to end the half. That really made it. I think going into halftime, the ability to go for the onside kick.
3rd and 1. Newton keeps it. 1st down at the 15-yard line.
And they're going to hurry. They're going to hurry.
Look at Malzahn.
Yep.
Get out there. Newton now with an even 100 yards rushing. Brandon Mosey, number 75, looks back. Dyer, right side. Not much there.
Yeah, well stopped.
D'Angelo Tyson, number 94, makes it. Well, Cam Newton has now become the 8th overall to pass for 2,000 and rush for 1,000. First from the SEC. Ah, you say. What about that kid that played at Florida? He never rushed for more than 1,000 yards in a single season. He did score 20 touchdowns rushing and threw for 20 in a single year, and that's within reach of Cam Newton. Now, here's Newton, right side.
Same play he scored on before.
Fights for additional yardage.
I think it's just instincts. When you see this guy coming, the linebackers, when he comes across with that speed sweep, you have to try to get outside with him, and you end up overrunning it and take the block inside by Mike Berry that time.
3rd down, 2.
As much as you're taught by your coach to stay disciplined with your eyes, I think that speed guy going across the formation really gets you out of whack.
106 yards. 5 times this year he has rushed for more than 170 in a single game.
Yeah, they're going to have to take a timeout.
Yeah.
You don't see Auburn mess up formations much. They probably practice formation, aligning for formations in practice more than any team I've seen.
21-21, important 3rd down coming up. We'll be right back. The Home Depot SEC on CBS is sponsored by Ally Bank. The Home Depot. Ford F-150. And by Bud Light. 87,451 paid in attendance. That's a full house, as you can see from 2,500 feet up. Aerial coverage of the SEC on CBS Sports provided by MetLife. 3rd down, 2.
Are you just tempted to give it to Cam 2 straight plays and say no way they can stop us twice in a row? I mean, you went onside kick. Do you want to get 7 points? Obviously, but, you know, I mean, you just say we're going for it on 4th down also.
That's McCaleb with him. Here's Newton.
There's one.
Darts inside. It'll be 1st and goal. Pretty good option.
Yeah. His rushing average is going to go down, obviously, when he runs these short yardage plays. But his value remains high. And, you know, and it does feel, I just have to say, it feels like Georgia's doing a good job against him. I mean, that's how talented he is at throwing the ball.
Well, look at the Verizon red zone stats.
They got the overshifted power to the right again. The 2 tackles to the right side.
McCaleb is split wide to the left. Here's Newton going right. Cuts it up. Struggles. He's at the 2. It'll be 2nd down.
Mosley and Zimba. Power. Plus, they pull another guard. They actually put 4 offensive linemen to one side of the ball.
And there's an injured Georgia player down, D'Angelo Tyson. get some medical help.
And you almost wonder if that was Cam Newton that caused that pop right there, because he really put his head down or shoulders down and ran on that one with power. Turns it up. It was.
I think so.
Maybe his thigh or whatever.
Appears to be okay. He will walk off unaided. Opening moments of the third quarter. If you joined us late, it was not announced until 1/2 hour before the game that Cam Newton, whose availability was in question, particularly the last couple of days, would be the starting quarterback. Topic of so much conversation and speculation this week. Here's the handoff, McCaleb. Touchdown, Auburn. Ontario McCaleb. Wes Byram for the extra point. McCaleb from 2.
It's actually the same play that McCaleb scored earlier. Is going to come over. Watch Cody Burns here. Former quarterback gets moved out to wide receiver just enough to get in the way to make that crack right there. McCaleb turns it up. Boykin's the only one. He's not going to stop him.
Well, there's Trooper Taylor, wide receiver coach. He can be dangerous. Sunset in Auburn, Alabama. And the Auburn Tigers have scored 21 in a row. Opened the third quarter with an onside kick, and they get a touchdown from Ontario McCaleb, his second of the day, to go back on top by 7 points for the second time in this ballgame. They opened the game with a touchdown drive, a quick one, and Cam Newton scored from 30 yards out, 7-0. Georgia with 21 unanswered. Auburn came back to tie it up at the half and now has taken the lead. Byram, Boykin back, this time almost a pooch kick, and it's taken up at the 25-yard line. And Georgia's going to get good field position out of this at the 35. Sean Chappas, the fullback, came up to grab it.
All right.
Monday on CBS, don't miss a new episode of TV's number one new show, Hawaii 5-0. Monday only, CBS. Caleb King is behind Aaron Murray. Hand off to King, gets a good block from Chappas, but he still picks up only 3. Craig Stevens, number 46, with the stop.
Well, Georgia started this football game. Obviously, Auburn scored first, but then they had the nice drive, the turnover for a touchdown, and then the 4-play drive on the long touchdown pass. Okay, to AJ. The thing that strikes me is, with 5 minutes to go in the half, remember that? It was 21-14. They had the ball about midfield. Now they come back for their next real drive, and they're losing. A 14-point swing.
Second down here. That's Chappas, the fullback. A.J. Green in tight to the right. Play action.
Here he comes.
Murray in trouble. Nosa Igwe.
Yeah, but Nick Fairley. Yeah, but watch Nick Fairley on this one. They cannot block this guy. Inside. Igwe is going to get the sack, but they cannot handle, and that's what forces Murray up in the pocket for the sack. Clint Bowling, Ben Jones, and Cordy Glenn have not been able to handle number 90.
Third and 15. bump once for A.J. Green. Deep for Chris Durham. Who got it? Did Durham hang on?
Wow.
Oh, what a catch. What a catch.
Charvin Bell was all over this play, and Chris Durham just went up and took it away from him. Durham goes about 6 foot five, and he's become more than a possession receiver for Georgia.
Young man who missed a game with a bruised lung. Redshirt senior, sat out all of last year. That one good for 28 yards. Play action, Murray again. Deep down the middle, has a man inside the 10. It's Orson Charles, his tight end.
This time, Auburn did not play two deep zone. They played two safeties doubling. Watch the safety turn and run. There is no one in the middle of the field. They put it all on Darren Bates that time. That's just too easy. There was no safety even to be seen.
That is a gain of 36 yards that comes on top of the 28-yard pickup on third and 17.
This Aaron Murray is going to be a star, isn't he?
Into the corner, A.J. Green, DeMond Washington, that one's incomplete. Well, of course, Aaron Murray, Joe Cox, the starter last year, but Matthew Stafford, such a big part of Georgia's offense, now playing with Detroit in the NFL. This is their freshman comparison. Look at that. Murray all over the place.
Well, two things to point out, to be fair to Matthew Stafford. Matthew Stafford was a true freshman. Murray redshirted, and Matthew Stafford didn't have number 8.
That's a pretty good point. He's at the top of the screen. Tavarius King is the inside man. Hand off Ely up the middle. Touchdown, Georgia.
This Georgia team's awful impressive. This team has lost 5 games.
Rashawn Ely sat out of suspension the opening game of the season. Had a problem with traffic violation. Here's Walsh with the extra point. It's up and it's good. And we are tied again. We've been tied at 7-7, 21-21, now 28-28. More to come, as they say in the promos. Midway through the third quarter, Georgia has just had two huge plays, 28 yards and 36 yards, to set up a touchdown run by Rashawn Ely, and we are notched at 28 all. 7:54 to go.
Give half that touchdown to Chris Durham. That was a magnificent play.
Yes, it was on third and 17. This is DeMond Washington at the 1. Well, this is a critical weekend in the Southeastern Conference. Take a look at what's going on in the East. First of all, big game tonight down in Gainesville as Florida and South Carolina tangle with each other. Steve Spurrier trying to lead South Carolina into the championship game for the first time in that school's history. They joined the SEC in 1992, and Georgia, of course, trying to become bowl eligible. And out west, if Auburn wins tonight, they are the West champions. Doesn't matter what happens against Alabama in their next game. It only matters to those who follow Auburn and Alabama.
Well, and being number 1 in the country, too.
Well, yeah.
They ain't getting in if they lose a game, not this year.
McCaleb.
Jeez, this offense is... I mean, it just never stops. Under center this time. They don't do it very often. Speed sweep, looking straight down on it. Look at Cody Burns get out there and try to get some.
That's a 48-yard gain. They'll try Dyer. at right guard. And he moves it probably 8 yards when it's spotted at the 25-yard line. On second down, Dyer. Oh, what a great block he got.
He did.
Whoa, what a dandy. It's Cody Burns again.
Well, first it started up front.
Okay.
He ran right behind Lee Zimba, Mike Berry. Watch the blocking right up front. Run right at him. Zimba just blows his man off the line of scrimmage, and then Dyer just gets into the secondary.
On first down, Dyer breaks a tackle, gets to the 9.
There's another
talk
freshman.
A little bit about Lee Zimba.
Lee Zimba is a great story. You know what he said to us yesterday? I said, Lee, come on. All this stuff you guys going through, he said, if there's any group that can handle it, it's us. We've had all coaching changes, offensive coordinator changes, offensive coordinators fired in the middle of the year. The fifth-year seniors on this team and the seniors on this team can handle it.
Lee Zimba starting his 49th consecutive game for Auburn. Next game against Alabama, he sets a school record. Dyer to the 5.
You know, it's also happening here now. That is Auburn's 51st play. Georgia has 30. They are starting to get wore down. Remember, the goal for a Gus Malzahn offense. As you look at Dyer right there passing Bo Jackson.
I don't think he minds.
No, he didn't like that one, I don't think. I'm going the other way on that one.
Third down and short.
They're pretty close to getting the goal of 80 plays. They have a chance.
Here's Newton. Got it, first and goal.
And you know, Vern, they may need 80 plays because their secondary is getting torched.
Well, that is not news in this part
no.
of the country.
In fact, we almost could have bet on it. Georgia passes for 241 yards a game. Auburn gives up 241 yards a game. They're at 201.
Right. Yeah, this Auburn defense, particularly the back four, has been suspect. Here's a quick toss. Michaela Smith in front with the block. Touchdown, Auburn. Eric Smith out of the open. Everybody could see him lay the clearing ball.
So nicely put together. Did you see Auburn do the quick huddle and line up? What they did is outflank Georgia and with alignment and snapped it quick before Georgia could adjust. Pitched it and let him run.
Player down for Georgia on the far side of the field. Mark Richt with Hubert Owens. This is Cummings, the cornerback.
Watch the quick break out of the huddle. And what'll happen? Overload, only two people on balance to the strong side. Pitch it and go before anything can happen. And Eric Smith gets the block to spring him.
Now that was on Sanders Cummings, and now you understand the injury. Malzahn on the left. Here's Sanders Cummings.
See how well that's put together? That was the plan. Get down there. I know I'm going to run it. Quick huddle, line up, go on balance, toss it.
Wes Byram for the extra point. He actually missed one a couple of weeks ago. There's a flag.
The good news is you scored. Bad news is your defense has to go on the field.
They have an inclination to make it exciting.
Yes.
False start. 7-3 on the offense. 5 yards from the previous spot. We'll have the try.
Well, you talk about him and bingo. Lee Zimba has a sister, Roslyn, who's a journalism major at New York University. Said she watches every game and critiques him and the announcers. Byram's extra point is up and good. McCaleb gets the touchdown. Clearing block from Eric Smith. Auburn has an answer. Gus Malzahn kind of pleased with that. 35-28, 5:04 to go, third quarter. So we've got 20 minutes of play. They announced during the timeout that Michael Dyer had surpassed Bo Jackson's freshman yardage gained record. And a very nice moment. Jackson came over to congratulate the freshman. How about this thing?
There you go.
It's a moment Michael Dyer will never forget. Nor will the policeman. Five oh four to go, 35-28. Boykin to return another kickoff.
Run down on kickoff. They earned their scholarship, but it's fun to watch when they cover one the right way. The ball was kicked very deep that time and handled, I think it was Darvin Adams, the wide receiver,
yes.
One of their starting wide receivers that got the first hit.
Then Craig Sanders, a linebacker, came up to complete it. Caleb King is the running back. King.
Oh, it's real man football when you run the ball now.
That was Michael Goggins, number 49. And Josh Bynes, the middle linebacker, was also in the neighborhood.
I love watching these games when neither side will take a step back. Georgia's playing it. Auburn's playing it. That time Josh Bynes played it.
Second down and 7. A.J. Green, bottom of the screen, hit screen. He's got Tavares King out to block. Lamon Washington was all over it. Let's go back to the studio for this John Hancock update. Here's Tim.
Vern, Gary, keeping an eye on those one-loss teams. Penn State's Matt McGloin is going to throw his second pick six of the day. Travis Howard of Ohio State does the honors this time. 30 yards for the touchdown, now leading 31-14. 28 unanswered points. Back to you.
All right, Tim, thank you. Third down, 4. Georgia 3 of 6 so far, converting third downs. Aaron Murray with the change. Josh Bynes with the defensive change. Murray, a lot of time. Across the middle, in and out of the hands of his tight end, Aaron White. There's a flag back at the feet of Nick Fairley.
I think Nick Fairley got a little frustrated. He's been getting double teamed. Watch
personal
this.
Personal foul. Roughing the passer. Number 90 on the defense. 15 yards from the previous spot. The penalty carries an automatic first down.
He has to go through Bowling and Jones, and then late, very late, he comes back and gets the penalty. And that's a third down conversion, and that was a bad one.
Did you see Aaron Murray react?
Yeah, so he knew it.
After the flag came, gave it a little fist pump.
Nick Fairley has to find the ball in the quarterback's hands. That's a bad one. That's one in the NFL you're going to cost you money.
That would have been a punting situation.
It's a fine line, though. He plays at such a high octane.
A.J. Green in motion to the left. Here's Murray pump once. Chased. Pulls up. That's thrown away. Second down, 10.
It's hard to turn off those guys right there. They're in the pits. They're getting hit every play. You're telling them to be aggressive. You're telling them to go in there and break up the blocking, and then you're telling them to be nice. It just doesn't work.
Don't forget to put a 20 in the offering. Second down. King shed a tackle, picked up a first down. Out across the 45, and he got a big block from number 49, Sean Sheppes.
Well, this is just bad defense by Auburn. This ball play was run right into the teeth of the blitz that time, and Auburn ran right by it. They're going for the quarterback, and they did not account for the run play first.
Looks like Zach Etheridge might have been shaken up on the play. He comes to the near side.
And he's important.
Yes.
He's the experience back there. They've got a lot of youth.
Ball just outside the 45-yard line.
Demetrius McNeil now goes in.
Freshman. Green in the slot to the left. Murray is chased. Here comes Fairley. There goes the ball. It's a first down. And guess.
No, he dropped
it. He dropped it.
It might have been knocked out of his hands. This might have been a good defensive play here. I think Demetrius McNeil might have got his hand on it. Let's see. Yes, you got to give that one to the defense on that one. McNeil comes off the bench and makes the play.
McNeil, a freshman. Out of College Park, Georgia, and near the Atlanta airport. Hometown also of Cam Newton. Second down. 35-28 with under three to go, third quarter. Murray.
Got away again.
Pulls up, fires. Caught at the 35. A.J. Green.
I tell you, Aaron Murray on this one. Watch this play coming from the left side. Corey Lemoner comes in. He spins out of it. Now he says, slow down. I got you, AJ. Come back and help me. Watch him lift the ball. Help me. I still got the ball right here. AJ Green comes back and look at him throw it going to his left.
Green has now caught seven. For 137 yards. First down.
That's a wonderful play.
Hand off up the middle. Not this time. That's Washawn Ely. How about this performance by Aaron Murray? Ooh.
You know, he's 11 for 19. But I bet he has five throwaways in this football game. So he has, and he's spun away from two or three sacks at the same time.
Don't forget this drive was given new life on a roughing the passer call on Nick Fairley on a third down that was incomplete. Murray back. Across the middle again. A.J. Green again. First down.
Have no chance. No chance against A.J. Green. Last week, I thought A.J. was a little frustrated not getting the ball. Well, 2 weeks ago, excuse me, against Florida. But right now, DeMond Washington and Auburn, they might as well just go for the blitz because if they don't get to the quarterback quickly, they have no chance with this guy. Eight receptions for 157. Wouldn't be a bad offense to throw to him almost every third play.
Yes. He's inside to the right. Here's Caleb King, tries a sweep to the left, and poor tackling yet again. That's to Charvin Bell, who missed that one. Well, let's go down to Tracy Wolfson with more on A.J.
Well, guys, a lot of A.J. Green's talents on the field can be traced to some of his passions growing up. His first love, basketball. He was an all-state player at Somerville High School, won a state championship there. And he said he learned his eye-hand coordination from juggling, and he also learned how to ride a unicycle. He can do both of those things at the same time. And, hey, guys, if he can't play in the NFL, he could always play and go to the circus, right?
Yep.
I can see him at Cirque du Soleil. Not. Second down. Murray into the end zone. Durham, it's too high.
Yeah, that's about the first one he's missed when he had an opportunity.
Third and five.
Chris Durham tries to get up there and grab that thing down with one hand. You know, the other positive for Georgia is that this will be the 11th play of the drive, so they've been able to give the Georgia defense a much-needed rest.
Third and five, and Green in the slot. Goes left side. They tried to set up a little screen in the left. Looked like Orson Charles was held up.
This was going to be a throwback screen to the tight end, and Darren Bates, number 25, stays with his man. Does his job, number 25, to the left side. That was never going to be thrown to the out there. That was a screen all the way. Watch him do his assignment right there. That was going to be a throwback screen, and that was well defended.
Here's the field goal attempt, Blair Walsh. That's good from 28. A drive that was given new life on a roughing the passer call. Results in 3 points for the Bulldogs. The end of three, it's 35-31. We'll return to Jordan-Hare Stadium right after this word from your local station. Just a moment ago, as the teams switched ends to start the fourth, Cam Newton leading the Auburn Tigers toward the student section. 15 minutes to go. The undefeated Auburn Tigers trying to go 11-0. Georgia trying to become bowl eligible after a horrid start to this season. But they have righted the ship. They're 5-5. They trail now by four, as we get the kickoff to start the fourth. Vern Lundquist, Gary Danielson, and Tracy Wolfson. And here is DeMond Washington out to the 21-yard line. And so it's back in the hands of Cameron Newton. And again, we began the day talking about would he or won't he play. He has played and played well.
Yes, he has. But now we're going to come down to the fourth quarter. And will form hold is what I want to know. Auburn has won five close games in the fourth quarter.
Right.
Georgia has lost all five. South Carolina, Arkansas, Mississippi State, Colorado, and Florida. Now, what will happen in this game? They got something a little different. They've got a healthy quarterback, and they've got number eight. So let's see how this goes. Can Georgia win a close game this year? The difference from being number one and number two and being 5-5, obviously.
Saw that graphic. They haven't done much, nor has it's a handoff McCaleb again. They run the old Statue of Liberty play for the second time. Last time in the first half, a 40-yard gain eclipsed by an illegal block. This time they don't get much.
I think it was Orlando McCaleb that said, we just don't have trick plays. There's just our regular plays. They just trick people.
Second down, six.
I said Orlando, I meant Ontario, excuse me.
That's okay. I've never visited that neighborhood. Second down and six. There's McCaleb going wide to the left. Three wide receivers split out. Here's Newton, got that little hesitation.
Yeah, that's the one that, excuse me, bothers me a lot when I watch Cam just kind of stutter and stand there. I wonder why people don't go after him. Pull the guards, watch him wait, be patient, and then just follow inside with Isom.
Third and one. It's going to be Newton. Well, his yards per carry is going to be short, but he's well over 100 yards. Let's go to Tim Brando for this Heisman watch presented by Nissan.
All right, Vern. Well, Andy Dalton does it in the air rather than on the ground. This is the first of four touchdown passes thrown today. TCU are now rolling against San Diego State. And a little Pac-10 flair. Number one, Oregon is led by LaMichael James, and they'll try to stay unbeaten tonight at Cal. And Andrew Luck leads Stanford to Arizona State all tonight. Back to you.
All right, Tim, thank you. Auburn now 9 of 12 on third down conversions. Flag is down. This could be a free play. Well, Tim, with the update on the Heisman watch, of course, for the last half of this season, Cam Newton has been the leading candidate. And I welcome your opinion on how all of this turmoil is going to affect.
You know what I'm very proud of? A lot of the guys that do what I do around the country have been saying, hey, let's just judge what's on the field and try to disregard what's going outside until it's proven. I think a lot of people are taking a healthy view of this, a mature view of this, and I think that's the way you have to do it. In my mind, in the 20 years of doing college football, Cam Newton's the most valuable player I've seen for his team, and I'll tell you why. Most of these other guys, Oklahoma, Ohio State, Texas, Florida, Alabama, had 10, 12, 15 guys draftable. There's not 10, 12, 15 draftable guys on this Auburn team.
And yet they are undefeated, and here's Newton. Nice catch, Emory Blake. Out on the left side, that's another first down. Cam Newton, that's a gain of 13.
Little square out. Delivers it, nice catch that time. Emory Blake had the early drop, but he has come back and redeemed himself. Of course, he's the son of Jeff Blake, quarterback.
That is the first pass play this half. And here's Michael Dyer around the left side. And gets near the 45-yard line. Dyer out of Little Rock, 8,000 yards rushing in a private high school there. Spurned the offer to go to the University of Arkansas. And he said it came down honest to gosh. He liked Gus Malzahn a little more than he did the folks at the university. Look at this. There is a flag on the offensive line. What do you mean there are no trick plays?
That's that gimmick play right there, right? We saw that at Arkansas before, didn't we?
Yes, we did.
The snap, everybody freezes. Georgia doesn't know what to do.
Offside.
Let me say this, though. Auburn, again, is approaching 300 yards rushing in an SEC game. They are rushing for an average of 325 yards a game in the SEC. That's 130 more than the second-place team, which is LSU.
Offside. Defense, number 42. The penalty is 5 yards from the previous spot. Second down.
130 yards more than the second highest rushing team.
Remember we saw them put, 440 yards on the ground up in the game here? They can move it.
Well, Georgia's moving it, too. They're 335, but these guys just produce yards on the ground. Just they eat it up.
Ain't nobody can stop nobody.
No, they got the two tackles to the right side again.
Yeah. Second down, and a little over 2 feet for the first. Here's Newton. Now Red Lobster presents today's Scholar Athlete. We're going to select Mario Fannin, a graduate of Auburn University, graduated last summer in public administration, pursuing a second degree in education. Red Lobster's commitment to the investment of our future is shown today by donating $1,000 to Auburn University's General Scholarship Fund.
It's already six plays. This will be the seventh in this drive, reminiscent a little bit of that drive against.
Now they pass it back. It's a gadget play.
Got rid of it.
And he overthrows McCaleb. Cody Burns was involved. Oh, boy.
It reminds me a little bit of that Kentucky drive when they put the game away to kick the field goal late. What happens here, if they could drive this ball down and score a touchdown, they almost make it a two-possession game for Georgia. They would have to score two touchdowns, maybe, and only two possessions left for time.
Second down and 10. Newton now 10 of 13 for 124. Throwing the ball. Is he out of bounds? Yes, he is. So
he threw the fastball on this one.
Darvin Adams with the catch. That's a gain of 11.
Watch him zip this one. Steps into it and zips it. Boy, that one hit him right in the 8 and the 9, and you could hear it, couldn't you?
Dyer goes left. Not much there.
No hurry up. If you see right here, Gus Malzahn, who loves the hurry up, knows the clock is his friend now.
Second down, 8.
Second and 8. Option pitch. McCaleb.
Well defended.
Oh boy, was it ever. Out on the edge, Brandon Boykin, number 2. And let's go down to Tracy for this injury update. Trace.
Well, guys, cornerback Sanders Cummings, we saw him get injured on Auburn's last touchdown. He is out in the locker room right now with a right ankle injury, having x-rays, guys.
All right, thank you. Third down, 11. A four-point game, 9:34 to go. Fannin is on the field. Blake Burns and Quindarius Carr to the right side.
Here's that three-man look that Todd Grantham has come against the spread. With the spy.
Newton. First down, Auburn.
The spy who got lost. Because this time the guy spy that got blocked on this one, Mike Berry, got the spy. That's what I said before. But a spy, you need Ray Lewis.
Yes.
Got caught up in trash that time. Alec Ogletree was the guy who was spying, and he just got too tight to the line of scrimmage.
That was a gain of 14. Newton now with 25 carries, 138 yards.
No.
McCaleb. He gives away two. Oh, is it? Yes, it is, McCaleb. And Marcus Doughton, number 38, made the tackle. Player down for Georgia. That's Ruben Fallugi. So time has been taken.
How about the sophistication of the fans here? They're booing because they think that he's faking an injury to slow down the Auburn offense.
Right. Well, here's McCaleb getting tackled. The injury occurred on the other side of the field.
And now it's time for our Geico game recap.
Big question of the last 2 days was, would Cam Newton start at quarterback in this game or would he not? And the announcement made about a half an hour before the kickoff. Newton immediately scored the first touchdown on a 31-yard run. Auburn went up 7-0. But Aaron Murray had a wonderful first half. 3 touchdown passes in the half, including this beautiful strike to A.J. Green that gave them a 21-7 lead. McCaleb, Ontario McCaleb, cut up to 21-14 on the 4-yard run. And then Cam Newton with his 18-yard pass to Lutzenkirchen, where we were tied at 21-all at the break. McCaleb, third quarter, left side, 28-21. Rashawn Ely came back for the Bulldogs to notch it at 28-all. And then McCaleb on a 4-yard run around the right side gave Auburn a 35-28 lead. And just a few moments ago, a field goal from Walsh of 28 yards. And that is where we stand, 35-31 with 8:22 to go.
Well, Gus Malzahn now has to grab his best play. If you're Auburn, you do not want to kick a field goal and make it a game that it's a one-possession game. What does Todd Grantham do? Defensive coordinator for Georgia. Does he come after him? Does he dare blitz? Let's see if he does it.
Second down and 10. McCaleb fires it. Wide open! Lutzenkirchen for the second time.
Cam Newton fakes to McCaleb and goes to Lutzenkirchen. I said Malzahn's going to grab his best play, and he did, and it worked. Ogletree right here. Let's see if he freezes on the play. Fake the sweep, takes one step in, and it's gone. Takes one step, you freeze. I'll tell you what, when you have a Lutzenkirchen go by you, you know you froze.
I've never had that happen before. The Home Depot SEC on CBS is sponsored by LG, Geico, Chick-fil-A, and by Nissan. We welcome you back to Auburn. Remember the headlines over the past 10 days concentrated on the Auburn quarterback Cam Newton. Did or did not his father offer to have him sign a letter of intent, specifically in this case with Mississippi State? And it's been an agonizing, anxious-filled 10 days, but the decision made to let him play today, and look at the smiles. And Gary, I overheard you whisper he's played an almost perfect game this afternoon.
I really think. I mean, considering the way he's run the ball, he's 12 for 15 with two drops. You got to know he's under pressure. You have to believe that. And then here's the other thing you think of. This stuff isn't going to stop.
No, it will not.
Everybody will reload.
Absolutely.
In this game, this is a sanctuary right here for the Auburn fans. Everyone is going to reload, and it's just going to start again tomorrow or Monday.
Well, he was allowed to speak to the press on Tuesday, an unfiltered 10 minutes, and that was the last time he really became available to the media, including us, by the way. And there's a special team stop at the 13. We requested a meeting with Cam Newton. It has been normal in our previous two visits here, and we were told that he was inaccessible yesterday afternoon. Understandably, you know. But I would imagine the press conference in the aftermath of this game is going to be fascinating. Georgia. Aaron Murray, 12 of 22 for 244, three touchdowns, but they now trail by 11. Rashawn Ely, that's a first down for the Bulldogs. A little bit of a hurry up for them.
Well, we will have to say that the Georgia offensive line has done a decent job. This time, plenty of time for Murray. Good job up front. A lot of space to throw the ball, and I think you're going to see what the rest of this game is going to look like. You're going to see draws, screens, short yardage runs, obviously, but mostly it's going to be passes from Murray.
7:30 to go. Murray short, dropped. Have a Sean Chappis, the fullback. Play fake. Murray has to tuck it, shakes a tackle, hit from behind. An official goes down. Lost his helmet. Where is it? To Charvin Bell. There you go. That's Russ Pulley. Hatless.
Right at him.
Boom.
A little bit of a backlash and then gets run over there by, was it Josh Davis?
Yes.
This was Josh Davis. It's got to be four down territory. There's not enough time yet to punt this left to punt the ball.
Third and four. Blitz threatened. Murray with the chain.
Oh, they're coming.
As they do, got him.
Ball's out.
From behind. Who got it? Looked like Antoine Carter with the hit. And apparently Georgia with the recovery.
You'll see the blitz inside, and then Carter comes around the outside and makes the play. Inside, Carter comes right around the outside and beats Sturdivant. And they're going for it. Basically, this is a trip to Atlanta right here for Auburn.
Hit as he lets it go. Auburn football. Atlanta's only an hour and a half away.
And Nick Fairley made the play. Watch Fairley inside. Igwe also comes around, but Fairley gets the play. What a play. What a player. What a season.
Now, Nick Fairley has had some impact on this football
game. And I was down on the field. This is a much bigger man than you realize when you're watching it on TV. 6'5", over 300 pounds, all-out north-south player. He demands two guys block him most of the game. And when he turns upfield, he is a sack machine. And you saw him reach for the belt. He's the champion tonight. Heavyweight champion today.
5:42 to go. Auburn with a victory cinches the SEC West. And a berth in the championship game. They're currently second in the BCS standings. That's not going to change after this one is over. Let's go back to Tim in New York.
All right, Vern, how about eight in a row now for Virginia Tech? Tyrod Taylor finds Marcus Davis with his touchdown catch to make it 26-10. The Hokies must beat Miami next week to clinch the Coastal title. If they can do it, they will. NC State, Maryland, both winning, creating a three-way tie with Florida State for first in the Atlantic. Back to you.
All right, Tim, thank you. Second down here, 5:07 to go. Cody Burns, Cameron Newton, first down. Flag is down.
After the play was over, personal foul, unnecessary roughness on the defense, number two. That penalty is half the distance to the goal from the end of the run, first down.
Well, Gene Chizik, how about the job he's done in this game, Vern? He's one of those second-year coaches. Remember, in the second year, Bobby Stoops, Tressel, Urban Meyer all won national championships. He needs two more to get in a national championship game in his second year.
Well, we mentioned Gene was a defensive coordinator here for 3 years under Tommy Tuberville. Went to Texas, worked with Mack Brown. Here's Newton on the first play. Freeman is down. Oh, they flew at him.
Anything Vance but a turnover Cuff. Right now.
Cuff took a shot.
Yeah, well, you can't blame Vance Cuff. I mean, on this play, you don't know if Cam Newton's going to turn up and run or he's going to slide. Let's look at this play. He's got a 6'6", 260-pound guy, and I wouldn't throw the flag at him. They would in the NFL, but I wouldn't do it in college.
42-31. Hug of the eighth. He's about to lose his second. Somehow right now that's not really relevant.
Just think about it. Nick Saban in his second year went 12-2. Remember, he was number one before he lost his last two games.
Newton, he went down inside the 10. Aerial coverage of the SEC on CBS Sports provided by MetLife. 3.5 to go. Georgia uses one of its allotment of three timeouts. We'll be right back. We mentioned a moment ago that Gene Chizik, 3 years on the staff here, then Mac Brown at Texas. He was hired as the head coach at Iowa State. He was there for 2 years. His record at Iowa State, 5 wins and 19 defeats. With a victory here in his second season at Auburn, 19 wins and 5 defeats. He's getting to 500. McCaleb, flag is down. McCaleb is as well. So that'll stop the clock with the penalty flag down. And you think back, I mean, I vividly remember when they let Tommy Tuberville go. Jay Jacobs, the athletic director, athletic council here, announced the hiring of Gene Chizik to come back home.
Yep.
And that was met with a chorus of boos.
Personal foul. Face mask. Defense number 2. That penalty is half the distance to the goal from the end of the run. Carries an automatic first down.
And then they, you know, he came in.
Yeah.
He's an easygoing guy for the most part, I think.
Well, at least that's the way we see him.
Yes, right? Exactly. Right. Except when he's saying no comment. And he said that to us a few times.
No, I saw him out at practice. He gets on his football team, I'll tell you that.
Well, he's about to go 19-5 at Auburn. Keep this team undefeated.
Well, it is an amazing story. I mean, you know, it looked like Auburn had a nice schedule, but nobody could have dreamed that Cam Newton was going to be this type of football player. Nobody.
Backs toward the goal line.
But let's.
And he stopped short. Well, this was the first touchdown of the afternoon. Newton from 31. This one deflected. Emery Blake dropped it, intercepted.
And then he put on a show. Pinpoint passing, over 100 yards rushing. He was on target all day.
2 minutes, 51 seconds. Go. Georgia's call time. Now, this was just about in the history books, 2:51 to go, and we invite you to stay tuned for the Jeep postgame show. Tim and Spencer, that's next on CBS Sports. Cam Newton, 29 carries, 150 yards. It's second and goal. Here's Newton. He fumbles it.
He did.
But he was across the plane. It's a touchdown. The ball got loose, but it was after Newton had scored the touchdown.
At least that's the way it's called on the field.
Yes, exactly.
Let's see what we got here.
Good point.
Pretty close, wasn't it?
Oh, it is. Well, we got that camera right on the goal line.
It is. I don't know if he got over or not when it starts to.
Ruling on the field is that the bio carrier broke the plane of the goal line. Touchdown.
Now remember, you do not have to cross the line.
Right.
You only need to touch the front end of the line. This is a big play here. Georgia's only chance is just a turnover. Overturn, excuse me.
And there is no stoppage of play for the review.
No, it don't stop.
Now it does.
Previous play is under further review.
Second look. Oh, he's got that. Yep. There he's going to get a touchdown on that one.
Yep.
You know, now, Vern, going first circle on this. What's going to happen? I mean, this story, as we talked about, it's not going away. Is this going to be like the Duke lacrosse case where the allegations never turned out? Or is it going to be, I can do a litany here. Clemens, Bonds, Daniel Monte, Rafael Palmeiro, Marion Jones, Ben Johnson. I mean, you know, this is what the sports public looks at. Like, how is this going to end up? This would be crushing for college football, this feel-good story, if it doesn't turn out the way it is.
I agree.
Right?
I go back to the action that Auburn took at the beginning of the year.
After further review, the ruling on the field is confirmed. It is a touchdown.
They made a decision to have Cam Newton play from the very first game.
Right.
Georgia held out A.J. Green just in case. Alabama held out Marcel Darius just in case. I believe the Auburn athletic department and the coaching staff were convinced by evidence we don't know about that Cam Newton was okay.
Right. I don't want to jump on a soapbox here. I want to just say this is such a great story. I think college football fans are saying, please don't break our hearts.
And now it's time for the Chick-fil-A player of the game.
Well, we're going to call it coach of the game this time, because Gene Chizik got his team ready in the middle of all this and got them to play a football game.
His record is now even at 24-24. Graduate of the University of Florida, 1985. I read a story this week, Gary, that Jay Jacobs, the athletic director, was asked when he decided to hire Gene Chizik, and he said the minute he packed his bags and headed to Austin to work with Mack Brown.
He knew he was a special one.
Yeah. The kickoff, Boykin. He's got to be exhausted. Down.
Can you imagine what it's going to be like? One of the great things, I think, for Auburn now, this is going to just be unbelievable emotion, winning for Lee Zimba, all he's went through, winning the SEC West. They're going to go crazy, but they're going to have that off week to come down, calm down, and then put their sights on Alabama.
No member of this Auburn team has ever defeated the Georgia Bulldogs. Four seniors in that offensive line. Zimba and his friends. Here's Murray. Caught. A.J. Green is just having an incredible night. Brandon Mosley, number 75. His insertion into the offensive line. His coaching staff attributes his starting to kind of solidifying
the final piece.
Yeah. Here's Murray airing it out deep left side.
Oh, he mistimed it. I've been watching him for 3 years. Might not get to watch him again on Saturday, but this is one of the few I've ever seen him miss time. Watch him go up and jump just a little too early.
Tasharvin Bell was defending. It's third down.
Tasharvin just said, I can't wait to watch you on Sundays.
Auburn about to go 11-0. They were undefeated in 1957. Ironically, on probation that year. Undefeated in 93. Ironically, on probation. Undefeated in 2000. and four and did not get invited to the BCAS championship game, and Murray is down. Ouch.
Let's see who gets them this time.
No, fairly.
Oh, geez.
Yeah.
He's being blocked inside on the play by Cordy Glenn, but he just keeps going. Right on the knee. That ball was clearly out of his hands again.
Hudson Mason is the backup, has played a limited amount of time this year.
Ball clearly gone, gets blocked on the play, falling into him, not called a penalty. And for Georgia and Mark Richt, they got to be holding their breath with their quarterback. Vern, they're 5-6. They got Georgia Tech
to get bowl eligible.
And they can't afford to lose that guy.
Right. Last time they missed was 96. Jim Donnan was in his first year as the head coach in Athens. I wonder if that couldn't have been a hyperextension.
Well, I know when I blew my knee, I walked off the field and I had to have surgery.
Really?
Yep. Never know.
So Mason is in. His first pass attempt as a Georgia Bulldog was a 26-yard TD, and this is going to be a handoff. And a fistfight breaks out.
Oh, Georgia has to stay on the sideline.
There were fists thrown.
Yes, but their players need to stay on the sideline.
Yep.
The Auburn players have not taken one step out.
No. Trooper Taylor.
They were coming after Nick Fairley.
Yep.
Why they were doing it.
And Trooper Taylor.
That was a payback. What? They were going to go after Nick Fairley on that play because of the shot on the quarterback. And to see what Mark Richt said, that's what you get when you don't call penalties on the guy. He's been hitting our quarterback late all day.
That was his brother, Josh Murray. I'm sorry.
That was Josh Murray, his brother. Watch. Let's see what happens to Fairley. Oh, yeah, they went after him. After the play.
That was Ben Jones, number 61, who was one of
the
instigators.
Personal foul, number 60 on the offense. After the play was over, personal foul, number 49 on the defense. He threw a punch. 49 is ejected from the ball game.
That's Goggins, Michael Goggins of Auburn Clint
Both
Bowling.
Both penalties are dead ball. They cancel.
That means that Michael Goggins, I believe, if I'm correct, is out for the first half of the Alabama game. And Trooper Taylor's doing a good job of keeping him. They need Fairley for both halves against Alabama.
So Goggins ejected. And the punch was right out in the open.
Remember, they play Alabama next. Even though it's 2 weeks away, he will have to sit out the first half. Boom, there's the punch.
And that has been confirmed, Gary. Fairley is on the bench. Sacked. It'll be third down. D4, number 95. Third and 16. Mason, the quarterback, handoff right side. Flag is down, thrown by the referee. He was back in
there. There might be another one. The Georgia bench is irate for that shot that Aaron Murray took late in the game. I mean, I could have been called a penalty unfairly. I don't think it was a dirty shot. He was going for the quarterback.
Yeah, I didn't think so
either. I mean, it could have been called as a penalty because the ball was clearly gone, but he didn't do anything maliciously on the play.
Multiple fouls on the play. Holding. Number 7 on the offense. That penalty is enforced from the previous spot. After the play was over, personal foul. Number 93 on the defense. He threw a punch. That penalty is 15 yards from the succeeding spot. It carries an automatic first down, and number 93 is ejected from the ball game.
And that's two defensive linemen. And if I'm Gene Chizik right now, I get my starters. I get them off the field. That's two starters that will not be available.
First half.
Against Alabama.
Against Alabama.
Both backups. I will admit they're both backups. But I'm getting all my starters off the field. And I might even call a timeout right here to preach to them what the ramifications are of getting thrown out of the game.
Chizzy was talking to his defensive line coach, one of the great players in Auburn history, Tracy Rocker. Now they're going to take a knee and get out of here. Well, it's an unfortunate ending to this game. But a Gatorade bath for the Auburn head coach. They are the champions of the SEC West. Aaron Murray able to walk out unaided. Cam Newton able to run toward the student section unaided. Here goes Newton up on the wall. Well, what's going to happen next? As far as we're concerned, the Jeep postgame show. Ole Miss and LSU next week. For Tracy Wolfson, Gary Danielson, Greg Silver, Steve Milton down in the truck, our entire crew. Congratulations to the Auburn Tigers. They are 11-0. We'll see you next week.
CBS Sports presents the Jeep Postgame Show.
We welcome you to the Jeep Postgame Show. Tim Brando in New York. A reminder, tonight on CBS, it's a lineup filled with drama and mystery, beginning with The Mentalist, followed by Hawaii Five-0 and a new edition of 48 Hours Mystery. That's all coming up tonight, only CBS. In the game you just saw, Auburn punched its ticket to the SEC Championship game by beating Georgia 49-31. Now let's go back out to Auburn, where Tracy Wolfson spoke with Tigers head coach Gene Chizik a short time ago.
Coach, after everything that happened this week, the allegations, the will he, won't he, how were you able to get your team to stay focused, win the West, and beat your rival today?
I cannot give enough credit to our seniors. We are so blessed, man. We have 20-plus seniors. They never sweat. We were down 14 points in the game tonight. We were playing sloppy at the beginning. They never get down. They never lose track. They just stay focused, and they find a way to win. And that's how we did it.
And how about Cam Newton and the resiliency he showed coming out here and playing a nearly flawless game?
Let me tell you something. He's a rock. He's solid as a rock. This is one of the best young men I've ever been around. I am so proud of him. He played a great game tonight along with the rest of our football team. Right now, we deserve to be the SEC West champs.
Congratulations. Enjoy it.
Thanks, Tracy.